Watching Southland TV, and I'm Melissa Fedora. We're here today in beautiful downtown Frankfurt at the Rustic Barn, located at the corner of White and Kansas Streets. Come on with us, we're going to go inside and meet the owner. Thank you for joining us. We are inside the Rustic Barn now, which is located inside the Trolley Barn at Kansas and White Street. I'm here with the owner, Carrie Mitchiff, and Carrie's going to tell us a little bit about her store. Carrie, how long have you been in business now?
Just a little over a year now.
Okay. And what was the inspiration behind why you wanted to open your own store? This is your first store you've ever opened, correct?
This is my first business that I've owned, and basically I just wanted to work for myself and be a business owner and make my own hours. And, you know, I really enjoy taking things and turning them into something else. And once I realized I liked doing that and I had talent at it, then I was like, I'm going to go full, you know, just I'm just going to do it. And I did it, and now I'm here. So, yeah.
Very good. So why would you name your store the Rustic Barn? We haven't really looked at anything yet here, but tell me a little bit about what products you carry.
I carry a lot of stuff made out of barn wood, like this cabinet, antiques, vintage. I paint furniture, just a big eclectic mix of different things. But I personally like the country rustic look, and with the name, I felt like I was really just going to capitalize on the popularity of the rustic.
Sure.
Popularity. So
yeah,
so the Rustic Barn, and I love the name, and I really believe in it. So yeah, that's why.
That's definitely in right now. So how do you get, you have so many unique things here, and we're going to walk around the whole store and look at everything. How do you get these things? How do you know that, oh, this is something that I need? Because everything here is so neat. So where do you find it? How do you do this?
Sometimes it's people I know give me stuff that they don't want anymore, and then I paint it or turn it into something else.
They see something rustic, they think of you.
Yeah, or just something old, and then they think of me, and they think she can do something with this, and then I do. Or I have vendors.
Okay.
I have a couple vendors that bring their own stuff in, and they, you know, sell their stuff here.
Sure.
Garage sales. I like to go locally to garage sales and give money back to the community too, and then bring their things into my store. And I love it when they come in and see it here or see that I've changed it and made it something else. So yeah.
Because you are sort of the repurposing queen. You're going to show us a few things that you've repurposed,
yeah.
But I know you can see something and you can say, you can totally turn it into something different,
right,
and repaint it.
Yes.
How do you look at something and know, I'm going to take this table and make it into, don't you have like a doggy bed over there or something?
Yeah, I really don't. There's just something, I always see what something should be when I look at it, and then I just do it. So yeah, I just see it.
It's just a gift.
Yeah, yeah.
Were you always into things that were maybe a little bit vintage when you were younger, or was this something you kind of grew into?
I've always been into decorating, and I always thought I would be an interior decorator or something like that. And I would still like to do that, and may still do that someday. I'm open to going to people's homes and helping them decorate. So we'll see what happens in the future with that.
Very good.
Yeah.
Thanks, Carrie.
No problem.
So we're still continuing to talk with Carrie, and Carrie is going to start something new and exciting here. Carrie's been doing some craft evenings, some projects here, but she's expanding it now, and they're becoming more common, and they have their own space, and you can even do drop-in crafting. So Carrie, tell us all about that.
So I've always done where there. I have a few nights a month where people come and make things, such as we've done a rag tie wreath, we've done growth charts, we've done Christmas signs, other holiday signs. I have three coming up this week, and now I'm in the process of transforming this room back here into a permanent craft room so people could walk in when they're shopping and decide to make a sign, or it will just be set up for when I have my craft nights. So that is something that's going to be really fun and exciting.
Neat. Yeah. So what are some crafts that you have in your mind coming up that people will be able to do?
I have monogram signs are really popular.
Okay.
People can choose what they want to put on it, whether it's the year that they got married, a baby's name with the date that the baby was born. We also do Illinois signs. I have a flip-flop wreath one coming up, a bandana wreath one coming up, so all different.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you come up with these cute ideas?
Just think of them.
You're just great. So if people want to stop by, they can do that. But now you also have the classes where you can sign up ahead of time. So how do you sign up ahead of time?
I advertise on Facebook, so they would have to go to my Facebook page.
Okay.
And
Rustic Barn.
The Rustic Barn. Okay. And subscribe to my events. And once they subscribe, they'll get a notification every time I post a new one.
Okay.
Yes.
And these classes are always very affordable,
yes.
I believe, and all of the supplies are included.
Everything's included. They could bring some wine if they want to.
Awesome.
I have light refreshments, and I make it as affordable as I possibly can. So,
okay, and people can even make an evening out of it if you're trying to have a girls' night.
Yep, if they want to book their own private party, they could do that too. So they
Great.
Could just contact me by calling me, or they could contact me on Facebook,
okay.
And I have a bachelorette party coming up.
Fun.
Yes.
Awesome. All right. Well, I think we'll be back to make some crafts.
Good.
Carrie, so I know some of the products that you have here, you not only buy and then sell as the way they are, but you also buy and then repurpose.
Yes.
With your creativity.
Yes.
So you have two items here that you can show us that you bought and now you're selling as a repurposed new and improved item.
Yes.
So show me what these two items are.
Okay, so both of these items are things that were found at a garage sale. This was an end table that had two doors on it and now it's a dog bed. So I painted it with General Finish's milk paint.
Okay.
And then I added this cute dog bed to it.
Adorable.
And got rid of the doors.
I imagine it was one of those like kind of 1970s
yep.
with a big heavy door and like
yep.
a metal handle
yep.
on it.
Okay. One of those old vintage tables that
yeah.
everybody had back in the day, but
right.
now it's a dog bed and it's still a table.
And milk paint, which is like so hot right now
yes.
from the little knowledge I have
yes.
of rustic things.
Yes. Milk paint is awesome. And then this was a cedar chest from the 30s that I got at a garage sale, but it was not in good condition.
In disrepair.
Yeah. So we made it into a few other things. This is one of the things,
okay.
and that is a birdhouse.
Beautiful.
So when do you see a cedar birdhouse like this?
Probably never. It's like a cedar birdhouse hope chest.
Right. So you can take things that you have and make them into something new and use it in a different way.
So how do you see these things and know? You just know this is just like crazy talent?
This was my husband that did the birdhouse, and
okay.
that was his idea. So he's pretty talented too and has some great ideas also.
Oh, so there's
yeah.
a dynamic duo working.
Yes,
here.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Yep.
Thanks, Carrie. We have more repurposed items here that the dynamic duo of Carrie and her husband have made. So Carrie's going to tell us a little bit more about this really neat looking cross.
So this cross is made out of barnwood. My husband cut the barnwood and then made it into a cross, but took old barbed wire and wrapped it around it to give it this look. So we made a bunch of these and sold quite a few at the Frankfurt Fall Festival last year.
Okay.
So maybe we'll have some more this year also.
Ooh.
And then I also wanted to show you this window here. So I bought the window and someone bought it from me already, but it's still here because she asked me to decorate it for a child's room because they're going to foster kids and they're trying to get this room ready. So she's trusting me to decorate it to match the theme that she's going with for the room. So
adorable.
That's something else that I do offer too.
And these are more things. So you find these items and if somebody wants them even further customized,
yes.
then you're able to do that and paint it, change it, decorate it however you want them. So you don't have to just come here and say, well, I guess this is all I can buy. You can completely customize it to what they want.
Right. I customize things all the time. I personalize things. I paint things certain ways. Whatever somebody wants, if it's in my power to do it, I will do it.
Amazing. We're in one of the beautiful sections of the store here. What did you call this?
This is her side of the garage, and it's my friend Sandy that makes these signs. She makes really awesome signs. So this is her section, one of my vendors.
Okay. So really neat signs here, a lot of different sayings. I think everybody could find something that they like here, a saying that will suit their home. So something kind of nice to check out here. But we want to remind you that we are upstairs in the trolley barn, and you have a website and social media, correct?
Yes. My website is rustic-barn.com, and then the Rustic Barn on Facebook. I'm also on Instagram, Rustic Barn Frankfurt. So we're upstairs in the trolley barn. The trolley barn is located at 11 South White Street. I'm suite 202 upstairs. You can get to my store from inside the building or from the outside entrance.
Okay.
And I'm here closed on Mondays.
Okay.
Tuesday, 11 to 5. Wednesday, 11 to 5. Thursday and Friday is 11 to 6. Saturday, 11 to 5. And Sunday, 11 to 3.
Okay.
Any of those hours, you can come here during business hours and make a sign. You could message me on Facebook or call me ahead of time if you want to let me know you're coming and tell me what you're interested in making, and then I'll work it out with you.
Okay.
But yeah, come here.
And I do know that you post a lot of the items that you have in your store. You do post those on Facebook.
Yes.
So if somebody sees something that they like, they could always send you a comment, send you a message, and you can respond to anything quickly.
Yep.
I know you're great on all the social media.
Yep.
So do come upstairs to the trolley barn. There's a lot of great stores downstairs. There's a lot of great festivities here, especially on Sundays for farmers markets.
Yes.
Fall Fest in September.
There's
car shows on Thursday.
There's girls' night out events. The next one is June 16th. It's Aloha Girls Night Out. It's a Wednesday night. You can dress up with a lei and a Hawaiian shirt. All the stores around here have specials and wine samples, and it's really fun. Everybody always has a good time with the Girls Night Out events. So come downtown Frankfurt. Come upstairs in the trolley barn, and please check out my store.
Wonderful. Well, I think a lot of people are going to be here because there's a lot of really neat things here to see. And as Carrie said, she'll customize anything you want. She repurposes all these great things. She has great people that she gets items from in the store. So come out, check her out, and you won't be disappointed.
For watching Southland TV. Keep up to date with what's going on in the community. If you would like to showcase your business with us or have any advertising questions, then call us at 708-289-0221 or visit our website.